the sight of the beaver.
I've spent some glorious days in the English countryside over the years, enjoying the lyricism of the landscape, as well as some of this country's literary greats. When I was looking for a poem which had some possible connection to the Celts, no matter how tangential, I came across the poem The Lady of Shalott by Lord Alfred Tennyson. Published in the 1830s, it came from a time when people had time to compose and listen to long stories. I was struck by the imagery as well as the narrative. My quest was then to evoke that pastoral picture captured in Tennyson's poem, and which I myself had been privileged to witness off and on during the 1980s. I wanted to paint the average folk with the accordion texture and create lyrical lines which would represent the landscape. The metronome-like quality of the balalaika was intended to emulate the canter of Sir Lancelot's horse, which is depicted in the narrative of the song, and which would have been the mode of transportation in Tennyson's day. Some of the imagery which spoke to me the most was actually that of the reapers reaping early, piling sheaves well into the evening and below the gaze of the moon. I still see this activity in the area where I live in southern Ontario, where there are Mennonite and Amish living and farming in 19th century ways. Having grown up myself around a farm and being familiar with some level of manual labor, I can relate to that sense of place and purpose, the rhythms of the seasons, sometimes even the rhythm of the task you're doing, sometimes in beautiful outdoor settings, and the feeling you are one with your manual task, who you are and what you are doing, how it grounds you to the earth and your own survival. Of course, it can be easy to romanticize these kinds of things, and I'm well familiar with the less comfortable and scenic version of farming life. At the same time, it is an analog experience of connection and belonging no kind of contemporary technology could ever replicate. And I'm grateful to have had the opportunity to creatively work with a poem like this and share it with so many people around the world.
Curses on her if she stayed to look down to Camelot. She knows not what the curse means.